Hello and welcome to Paint Shop Pro Basics episode 51, the Mesh Warp Tool. The Mesh Warp Tool, found right down here underneath the pen tool, click the little triangle. It's technically after the warp brush, but the mesh warp is a little bit easier to go through right away. The Mesh Warp Tool is a distortion tool. Unlike the push tool, which just grabs an area and copies it continuously, or the smear tool, which mixes things, or smudge tool, I'm sorry, not smear, smudge. This just distorts the image. And here you can see when I've got it activated, we get these columns and rows of line segments with nodes on them. Essentially what you're going to be doing with these is you're going to drag a node around and it's going to go ahead and distort the picture underneath. The pixels closest to the node will be stretched the most. The pixels going away, you can see the curve here. The pixels furthest away will be adjusted less, so the fewer nodes here, the more effect a single node has on the image. Now, you cannot move nodes past other nodes at all. They kind of get stuck down there. Also, the nodes here at the side or the top of the images can only be moved along the edge. They cannot be brought in at all. So you're kind of stuck there. It's not a big deal. Just thought you should know. Now, there are three ways to adjust nodes. The first way I already showed you is to just click and drag them around. The other way is to hold down either the shift or the control keys. When you're holding down the shift, the cursor will get this little line segment over top of it, and if you click and drag upward, it moves the entire row in a straight line. Undo that. And if you hold shift, click and drag left or right, it will move the entire column. With control, however, we get a nice curve symbol over our cursor. And if you drag up, the other nodes will follow the node you've dragged in a nice smooth curve. So you can get slightly smoother results by control clicking on these nodes. And again, direction up and down will control the row, left and right will control your columns. So I'll go ahead and undo all that. So what determines how many nodes and lines we have in our mesh? Well, that's right up here in the mesh horizontal and mesh vertical number groups. Right now I have these set to 4 each. And you can adjust them to up to 31 lines, or I'm sorry, not lines. Mesh horizontal is your columns, so up to 31 columns and up to 31 rows maximum per image. So that's quite a few, but let's face it, you don't want to get too many. The more, great point to bring this up, the more nodes you have, the more Paint Shop Pro has to adjust the image in relation to all of the other nodes. The more nodes you have, the less room you have to move a single node. So at all times, the overall control of a single node becomes smaller, the more you get. And because it has to adjust according to all of these, it takes a lot longer to process, especially on larger images. Next, we have this little checkbox right up here called Symmetric. When this is turned on, it's going to automatically adjust the number of rows and columns so that the space between them is a perfect square. And it's always going to do this in relation to the last variable that you edited. For example, I edited the verticals last, so the horizontals were adjusted for me. If I adjust my horizontals, the verticals will be adjusted to, again, maintain these perfect squares. And it's pretty simple. That's best for square images, but at the same time, it's really good for making sure that there's even amounts of spacing between the different nodes. The checkbox underneath that, Show Mesh, is really handy if you want to find out what your final result looks like and you think that the grid gets in the way. Here I've made a quick edit. If I go ahead and hit Show Mesh, it hides the grid. I can't adjust any nodes while it's hidden, but so it hides the grid and I can see what the final result might look like. This is really nice because it also doesn't accept the changes at all. Next we have Edge Mode. If your distortion ever causes the edge of the image to pull over, you have different ways of filling in that extra space. Background will, if you have a regular background raster layer, it will fill it with the background color associated with your materials palette. If it's on a raster layer, you know, a regular raster layer with a alpha channel, it'll fill that in with transparency. Fixed will make sure that the edges never move at all, and so they will simply get stretched, but your edges will be your edges. Wraparound actually grabs information from the opposite edge and drags it around to wrap up with the distortion. Draft quality refers to the amount of detail that you see while working on the mesh. Higher settings will take longer to calculate, so especially on really large images, you want to keep this pretty low. I have mine set to medium at all times unless I need to bring it down more. Of course, coarse is the lowest setting, so you'll get lots of pixelation, but it should be noted that just because your draft quality is set here, that does not mean that's going to be your final result. Final result is determined by this one. Best quality. If this is turned on, it will always strive for the best quality distortion that it can. It will try not to pixelate anything. It will do its best. If you turn this off, it's going to use the draft quality. So what you see is what you get. It's essentially what you're left with. The last thing that we have up here is your deformation map. I'm actually going to leave this alone for now because the deformation map applies to both this tool and the warp brush tool. And so I want to get into that in a little more detail later on. But trust me, we'll get into that. And your final things are apply and cancel. Since each of these node movements is a separate action, if you hit cancel, it'll essentially just undo each and every single step. So depending on how many steps you've taken, this could take a little while, especially on larger images. The apply button will go ahead and accept your changes. And if you have your best quality turned on, it will recalculate how everything looks. Your other way to apply is to just double click on the image. When you're done, you have what you have. All right, I'm going to leave you there. Next, we're going to get into the warp brush tool.